Hey, what's up, guys, and welcome back to another episode of the FIFA 22 Aston Villa career mode. I believe it is episode number 23. As I just uploaded episode number 22. Anyways, before we get into the career mode, I want to show you something. Now, with FIFA 23 around the corner, it is the time of the year again where we get the trailer and the leaks and then, you know, the special thing. And the first bit of information we got from EA is FIFA 23 cover star. Now, we have two cover stars. Obviously, Mbappe is his cover star. He will remain as a cover star if it will show. There we go. Okay, we don't have to advance just yet. So, we also have Sam Kerr, who is the Australian Women's and Chelsea Women's FC attacker as well. I think she's a striker. Sorry, mate. Women's going on, that just isn't that good. I don't really watch it. Like that. I don't know if I've ever seen it. I have ever watched a game of women's football, to be honest. But, you know what I'm saying. So, I want to get people from the chat and YouTube section, comment section. Do you think EA are going to do something different with maybe like adding in some like female league or something into the game? Like, I genuinely think they might, because they would not add her. And by the way, she's the first ever female footballer star to be on a FIFA cover star, right? So it tells me that potentially they're gonna do something a bit different this year. They're gonna add some female leagues, or imagine female career mode. That would be pretty sick. I'm pretty sure, yeah, the World Cup isn't on. The female World Cup isn't on this year. It's the male. So so I'm just thinking they could do something. They could do something very, very interesting. But first up though, enough of that. Let me know what your thoughts are. We have got West Ham, Norlang. I'm quite enjoying him. I think he's very, very good. He feels quite good. Ramsey has been doing alright. We just need to give him more game time, train him up. I'm already giving him, I think, a development plan as well. So, you know, he got to 75-76 soon. I'm gonna convert him to a cam, a proper cam, because I want him to buy cam. But I want to get his development plan done first, because obviously you can do both at the same time. Leon Bailey, still enjoying him. Like, at the start of last season, I've changed my opinions on him. McGinn is alright. Douglas Luiz is good. Did score a beautiful goal in the last episode. If you guys haven't checked it out, the title is basically just what, Wonder Goals. Dinye in there as well, and then Badashin, who actually doesn't feel that slow, but I'm gonna bring Mings back in. I wanna go take between two of them, you know. I wanna see who feels better. Right now I can't really say much about them, so I wanna just rotate them, see who I prefer more. Konza is still as good as possible as always. Cash. Chambers just doesn't stand a chance to play, does he? And then we got Martinez, who I promised to bring out for Ilan Meslier, who will make his Villa debut, whatever. He's left foot at 6'5", a tall, tall machine like Areola. I promised I will play him, we got Ings, Traore, Buendia, Sanson, Watson, Pyroshield, Chambers. So I'm happy the first team. I think in January and even next season, I'll be looking to upgrade a few, maybe a couple of first team positions, but definitely the bench. Like, Charlie, I'm just not getting much use of. Sanson, you know, if I can sell these two for some money, get one player in who can be maybe a winger who can play as a center attacking mid or center mid, something, or attacking midfielder who can play off the wing, that would be cool. And then we just have to move one of these guys onto the bench. Like, I wouldn't mind getting this, sell the two of them, and get a better winger, you know what I'm saying? I just wouldn't mind. And then Martinez will be dropped for this game. We gotta trust the players we bring in, you know. I do not spend like 27.5 or whatever million on Meslier just on the plane. Anyways, in the table right now, they're chilling in second. We're behind City. We're tied with United. We're ahead of Leicester. So that's the top four. West Ham, West Ham and Mark have been on 12th place. 1 win and 1 draw, 2 losses. So 4 points out of 16. Not that great. But let's get into the first game of the episode. The off is on. Spread it to the other side. Noah Lang. Yeah, post finish. It's Noah Lang. Who's made it 1-0. I love this guy already. I love him. It's been 5 games into the Premier League season. Wow, that scared me. And I absolutely love him already. Come on. Is it Kurzuma? Ain't got Noah Lang. But what a goal that is. Look, like, the Zuma situation, like, pretty much gave my thoughts on it, to be fair. Yeah, I mean, let's not talk about those kind of stuff. 1-0, they've got Tots. Tots. Vet. Okay. Isn't he from Genk, I think? Or is it Ghent? I can't remember, bro. Those two matches look the same. Those two clubs sound the same. They're basically the same at this point. I'm in love with Marlene. He's my favorite player. Watkins hasn't shown much anymore this season. Penrith! What? No, Melier again. It's ever again. On a suit at night. Ooh. Good save from number 13. It's definitely not Fabianski, it's not Areola. Is it like Martin or something? Oh, is it Nico Martin? Nolan! Oh, it's Self. This is Strasbourg goal. Once again, Nolan. Douglas Luiz. He's another save on the goal lane. Make the pressure on this. Alex Iwobi. Jeez. I mean, Alex Iwobi is the kind of David Moyes signing, isn't he? He just feels like a David Moyes signing. Can we get a header? Ooh! It's like Ollie Watkins. Click on header. That was pretty close. Ooh. Just a little bit more and it goes in.
Alas, we had to cut her off just moments ago.
No. Yeah. I don't know where they got the pace from. Suddenly the pace just came out of nowhere. So, we're in below. I don't want Mink for doing it. I was going to control my Mink for doing it. I'm going to disappointed. He is where he is. That's good up. And below, man. How? Like, yeah, don't, as a defender, don't ever go on a challenge like that. Man, I was winning 1-0. What is that Jacob? How do you my cam? Oh, bring Coutinho back. Even Coutinho can't solve this. Noah Lang coming off wouldn't go. That's okay. I just don't know why. So I'll keep Noah Lang, but I'll put him left striker. Then need something. Left striker. Bailey. And I guess that's that. So we'll bring Buendia and Badashil on. Look, we can't afford the drop points. This will come back and bite us. I have a feeling it'll come back at the end of the season. We'll back. If we had the extra 2 points or something. Watkins! Oh my god, that's one. When I need you, Ollie, you give me that.
Oh, he can score here.
give us a penalty, man. Okay, I'll take it. Grab the ball, Noah. He's been like the only player. Oh, don't tell me. Noah Lang has been the only player that's been trying. Break their legs, get the ball back. No, not leave spaces for them to run into. No. Oh, man, he had to rescue us there. Could have been a goal as well. What are we doing? We need to win the ball back, not give them a goal. Get it out. What is that thing, yeah? Oh my god. Your left foot is horrendous. I play your right foot's better than your left footed. I'm just disappointed to be fair. Like, again, the same with Spurs. We could have done a lot more better, but again, if you play poorly, you get what you deserve. And I'm happy you got a draw. Do we really deserve a draw? I can safely say probably not. Anyways, next up we will have Manchester City in the Carabao Cup. I'm gonna go into 4-4-2, I think. Let's see how it works. We might switch into a 4-4-2 now. But look at the team. They've got Cole Palmer, Itakura, Palavesa as the only two players that are resting. So they are going all in for this. So you kind of look at that and be like, should I rest? If anything, the Carabao Cup is something that I don't really bother about. So many can play. Look, I don't have a proper backup left back. I quite literally have no backup to do yet. I think me can do a job left back. What do you think? He's a bit tall. Yeah, I just go by it. Badashi, Konza, Gilbert. In fact, let's play Chambers. That is my back four. I'm gonna trust these players. Right, I kind of want to play Noah Lang. I'm in love with him. I will play Noah Lang. Don Bailey can go there. Buendia, and then we swap up two. And then the midfield two, let's have Watson. And Sansong. You know what? We have Watkins and Ings. And let's put Noah Lang on the bench. Is there anyone else you want on the bench? Can I want Cash? The younger brother? Let's put him on for McGinn. Because we already have JJ. Give McGinn a bit of a rest, even though he doesn't really need it. And let's put Cash and give Dingy a rest. I don't want to bring him on. I think Cash can do a job left back, can't he? So that will be the team we go with. Noah Lang rested. I have a feeling no one's gonna care now. Who is that bald kid that's marking him? Palavesa. Okay.
So the action continues.
No wonder. If there was like Stones, Laporte, Diaz, Ake, Cancelo, Walker, never going in, mate. Never. They'll just slide you down and the ref wouldn't give a pen because it's EA. And he got a yellow card because I think of a previous foul. Imagine you make a mistake like that. You cross the goal, and then the next second you get booked. And then the ref comes up to you and like, oh, I booked you because you made a mistake. Nah, I'm joking. You found him. Oh man, yeah. He's quite good to be fair. Like you gotta invest, you know what I'm saying? You gotta invest. I think Rodak would have been a cheaper choice, obviously. He's low rated, like 6 million. But you gotta go with to a good try this. Cheeky. I thought I messed it up. I thought they were going to play. But Guendian makes it 2-0. How are we not able to beat a West Ham side with no disrespect, no offense, but then take a 2-0 lead over the City? It's not over yet. Like, I genuinely do not think it's over. You know, it's only 2-0. They do have Diaz in their team, but it's not over yet. They have powers on the bench. They have Brian probably, Cancelo. Is Cancelo playing? But you know what I'm saying, they've got the big stars on the bench. I won't be surprised if Herrera comes or for stuff. Calavera and even Palma. Just been poor, they've just been really, really poor this first 20 minutes in. I think with teams like Chelsea, at the start there was no one, everyone was like they're not doing business, but now they're just signing Koulibaly, they might sign Ake, I know they might sign Rafinha and De Ligt, still going to Bayern. But look, who would realistically sign De Ligt for 70 million euros when you can get Koundé for less? You know what I'm saying? Like who? De Ligt has been poor for you guys. He's not prime the late at Ajax. So how much did he went for to Ajax? If he went for more than what he went to Ajax, than what he went to Juve, Juve are making bucks. Definitely. His value should have dropped. I know he's still 22 and obviously one of the top centre-backs in the world. Form tells differently than this. I don't know how they spot these. Look, I know that they were gonna pass it there, but I just couldn't do nothing else. What is that? EA Sports are just... Like, why am I supposed to do that? What am I supposed to do? He's gonna go through, he's gonna whip my name. Go. There we go. Single lead cushion restored. 3-1 up now. To 66th minute. Danny Ings, we really missed him last season. I think had we had him, I think he would have been dead because look, we lost ourselves. A good player for the entire season. September, and then he went on for like 9 months or something, 8 months. Which is just not what you want, is it? I expect City to make some stuff from Jesus or you can almost expect what they're going to do. And that is also expected because it's failed. Yeah. Anyways, Sterling, offside. Second time is not. My players are tired, knackered. So my attack I think is fine. I've been watching on here, it's not quite well. Triple Mega. Joubert. Cash. I'm not sure Noah Lang on for Buendia, off the left. I'm really enjoying Noah Lang, man. I think his shown really, really good quality so far. Where are do what? Well, the sweat for you, I'm sorry. But why is it 3 minutes?
Advantage to any side when you're as comfortable on the ball as they are.
Massive victory. I would have preferred this in the Premier League, but look, like, through the next round, who knows how far we can go in the Carabao Cup, but at least we're not going to get knocked out first round. And just like that, Buendia is 82 rated. I'm going to combo him the left bit and I'll combo him back. It'll take him 2 weeks, but I want him to be able to play on the left because I do that a lot of times. Davies, not the right thing. If that was like Northampton or someone, I would like to play City. Next up though, we have got Leicester City at home, I think. It's at home. It is at home, yeah. Buendia wants to play. I'm gonna go and play my I really enjoy the 4-4-2 more than the 4-2-2 at the moment. So I'm just gonna go with my 4-4-2, which means Ramsey have a good job for now. In fact, I'm quite fine with that. So we have Noah Lang as the left striker. We walk it. Both 5-star weak foot, not only 4-star skills, walk it to 3-star, which I don't really care. So yeah, we got 2 5-star weak foot players up front. Final game of the episode against the City at home. Can we win to make this a good episode? Let's hope so. If that was me, it would be a shit man. You could literally feel. If that was you and you made a tackle with that. Oh, I forgot to take Melly out. No, I let him play every game this every game. So that he boosts his sharpness. No, yeah, I trust him. He's considered quite a few in the last two. He saved one, but he considered again. I don't think Martinez would have saved that, would he? Basically an empty net though. It feels like Spurs last year all over again. It's just a feeling right now. I legit feel like quitting right now. Like, just go. Who cares? Are you kids? I'm gonna sell you in January. I'm gonna sell you, mate. If you have no commitment, if you don't want to play, then just say I can take you off anytime I want. Truth, I'm gonna say one thing that no one can disagree with. Vardy should have put on the red card. He shouldn't even be on the pitch. Yeah. It's gonna stop this game. Only one in the team that's committed. You and Manny, the two new signings come in. They want to be committed. The rest, you know, the first two games, wow, we're in Wonderland. Then, you know. And after you say, if you're not committed, you don't want to play, you know, then no bother. You'll be gone in jail. You know. I'm truly disappointed with McGee because I do like him as a player, I do. But that pass that is enough for me. Yeah, I do like McGee, but that pass that gave Leicester a third goal. This proved my point. No one is wondering. Many did a lot. I just couldn't do the defense. The rest is delayed. So So that will be it for this episode. Very, very disappointed. For West Ham and Leicester, we should have won. City, we won, then we shouldn't have won. So I would swap. I would quite literally swap. Next episode, we've got Arsenal away at the Emirates, we've got Southampton at home, and we've got Wolves away. The schedule might change, it might not be these three games, but I don't think they'll move Luton anywhere here. So yeah, it should be what it currently is. So that will be it for today's episode. Hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. Please like, share, subscribe to us on our